This morning, the center will be closing the end of April, basically due to significant capital cost on this aging building, increased in our operational programs. So we just don't have the current funding model that's available to keep a center like this open.
Okay, and how many people use this service? I know there are some apartments as well as the sort of the daily turnover of people, of the men that come through?
So we have a special care unit. It's a 40-bed unit. Currently there's 35 men using that facility, and also we have an emergency shelter, and it's a 27-bed facility. And over the last couple of months there's been about 15 men that have used that, so about half.
Okay.
Full.
So, any idea where these people might go? I know that you, I hear you're working on with other agencies to find
yeah.
spots.
Well, our special care, that's that they fall under the Department of Social Development. So the government will be working with us in placing these men over the next, you know, starting soon, over the next couple of weeks, and by the end of 30th, those men will be placed in alternative and suitable housing here in St. John.
Okay.
Our shelter, our men's shelter, we are currently going to be starting and have started dialogue with some community stakeholders, other agencies now that take in homeless men, working again very closely with the government on their housing first alternative. It's a new strategy on looking at homelessness in the city of St. John. I mean, I think it's a good news story that, you know, that the Center of Hope has 27 beds and we're only, you know, at sort of half capacity. So we're really going to look at what homelessness means in St. John and how can the Salvation Army play a role in that. We want to be part of it. We're not leaving the city. We have our St. John Corps here on Waterloo Street that offers emergency food, clothing, and shelter. So we will continue those services. It's just that we can't keep operating out of this current facility, but we will certainly still be offering these services in years to come.
What about who is employed here? How many people does that impact?
So there's 44 in total, and that includes full-time, part-time, and casual employees. And so we're working very closely with them on job referrals, on their severance packages. We don't take this lightly. We know this is, you know, hard news for them and for their families. And so we're doing everything that we can to work with them.
Okay. What's been the reaction today?
The reaction, surprisingly, I think, has been relief. I think, you know, for the last several days, there's been lots of discussion around whether the center close. And I think hearing it firsthand this morning brought some relief. They seem to take it very well. I mean, it is a sad day. No one likes to hear that they're losing their job. But the climate here has felt very, it's felt very positive. It's felt very warm.
Is there anything that could change this? Could some money, if some money came suddenly from another location, could that change this outcome?
No, I mean, in such an aging building with so much capital deficiencies, we wouldn't be able to keep running out of this center. And with this new homeless strategy alternative, we're really looking at homelessness and what that means. You know, so, you know, we likely wouldn't get back into a huge facility like this, like a 27-bed facility that's only at half capacity as it is in St. John. I think that's a good news story for the city of St. John. So this center won't be able to stay open under the current situation that it's in. But we are working right now with the government. They're very willing to partner with us on what a new model of care is going to look like here, to be more economical and to be more efficient in delivering our services and to the needs of people in the city of St. John.
Is it possible a new Center of Hope could open in a smaller, newer space?
Anything's possible. We're certainly not ruling out anything. We need to meet with this new Housing First strategy to sort of see what kind of role they need or want the Salvation Army to play, and then we have to decide, you know, what that looks like.
Provincial operation?
It's provincial, yes, okay. It is. Is it a smaller operation? Absolutely.
When is that meeting happening?
We're having ongoing discussions. We've been discussing, you know, with the government extensively about the future in the last 4 weeks, I would say. And so those meetings are just going to